Welcome to Problem Investigating Squad, short form for piss. I'm Fraser Keeney.
I'm Jordan DeCary.
I'm Peter Marsley.
I'm Josh Rogers.
And I'm Chris G. Chris Krzyzewna.
Chris Krzyzewna, what's today's problem?
We're going to be looking at youth delinquency at Twin Lakes Secondary School in regards to marijuana and loitering.
Jordan, what's the intel on what time of day they're committing these acts?
Seems to be after school hours.
Peter, who should we contact to get more intel on the crimes being committed?
We're going to contact Dave Townsend from the Orillia OPP.
Who should we talk to get more info on the issue?
The principal of Twin Lake Secondary School, Irfan Tor.
Okay, so Chris, I want you to go there at 4 p.m., collect video evidence. Peter, I want you to grab some muffins and then make sure everyone's doing their job. Okay, boys, we all know how to solve this problem.
Yes, we do.
Yeah, let's get it done. Piss on three. 3, 2, 1, piss!
We are here at Twin Lake Secondary School, and right now we're going to go walk into the forest. There's obviously no fence here. And this is where students hang out before school, during school, and after school. We clearly can see there's garbage here. Right there, everywhere we got garbage. So there's obviously signs of loitering in here. There's possibly maybe alcohol in here, alcohol bottles. Look at all this. This is incredible. All the garbage. Tissue paper. This is where all the youth meet. We even had testimony of kids that don't even go to the school and they still come here to chill out, hang, do their own thing, smoke, drugs, etc. How big of an issue is kids smoking marijuana?
It's pretty prevalent in this school. Lots of kids. Some kids have it on them at school. Some are just doing it at home recreationally.
I would say, considering the size of the school, we have over 850 students, I'd say it's a fairly small issue. I think in terms of smoking and alcohol and even marijuana, is that there's two categories of students. There are students who do it all, but they don't do it around here, and they don't let people know they do it. And then there are others that make it more public. So in terms of numbers, I would say that there's probably in the range of 50 students here who smoke.
Well, on like a really warm day, you probably see over, I'm going to say 50, 60 kids down at the section. So
probably half of them. I don't know. Yeah, probably like...
I'd say a good third.
Yeah, a good third of the entire school population?
Yeah, I would say that.
Probably at least half the school.
Half the school.
Really? Okay. And of that, how much do you think smoke marijuana?
I don't know, maybe 15, 20% of them.
Yeah.
About half the school.
it's more than it should be.
Yeah.
Yeah, like to compare it to another school, I don't know, but it's definitely more than it should be.
Can you comment on the parent involvement? Do you get parents involved in the issue?
Definitely, especially if something's going to a negative consequence, right? If somebody is going to be, you know, suspended or fined or detentions or whatever because they're actually smoking on school property, then of course parents get involved, or we let parents know. I wouldn't say that we let the average parent know that their student is smoking just randomly. I know in dealing with kids over the years that sometimes I'll find somebody has cigarettes or they were smoking on school property and I'll say, do your parents know? And then in a lot of cases the answer is no.
I mean, you can't blame everything on parenting and there's always an explanation for everything, but you know, education is a big thing, and I mean, kids will be kids and they're going to experiment anyways.
If marijuana was legal, tax regulated, etc., do you think this activity would diminish or vice versa?
Well, it's hard to say because cigarette smoking is still prevalent and people do that in public. I'm not sure if it would diminish. I think the hiding would diminish and people would do it more in public.
So it'd be more detectable.
Yeah, there might be there might be bins or places for them not to create as much trash when they're finished because they're not hiding out in a bush somewhere anymore.
All right.
Cool. But that being said, I don't condone it.
I think it would definitely, I mean, if you look at it now, smoking is, it's illegal for people under the age of 18 to buy cigarettes. And yet we have 14-year-olds walking around with packs of cigarettes that essentially have somebody has bought for them. So I don't think that legalizing marijuana will make anything easier or better around schools. I think it'll definitely make things worse, because then the presence of it, there will be more. Because people will, again, they'll misinterpret the rules and the law, and they will think that it's okay to bring it to school. One of the things related to that is e-cigarettes, right? And so we actually just have sort of had a discussion about e-cigarettes, and a lot of people don't know that e-cigarettes are actually illegal on school property as well, right? So, but we've had students, I've had students over the years who will stand in the hallways and smoke them. Right, and again, why are they doing it? I think they're doing it a little bit because they want people to see them doing it.
What are the charges being laid on teens involved?
Possession, just possession charges, depending on what they have, how it's packaged. There is kids that are selling it and making money off it, and that's a whole different area.
Well, if I find a student who's in possession, right, of marijuana, then we involve the police or alcohol. Probably alcohol too. I'm trying to think that sometimes alcohol, sometimes not so much. But then the charges come from the police make the decision to charge. So we make essentially the report to the police. The police make the decision to charge. And I think it is a case by case thing depending on how often it has happened. I've certainly had students who have something, are possessing and end up leaving the office in handcuffs. And I have had students who I know don't end up getting charged. What I think probably the thing that makes the biggest difference is quantity and packaging.
Mm-hmm.
So when somebody has it in one bag, that means one thing, and when they have 10 little bags, that means something else.
The diversion aspect is sort of making them more confident in this type of behavior.
Yeah, they're very well educated in what happens to them as per what happens after being arrested by police. They have an idea of, you know, community service, small fines, Elizabeth Cry program. Their friends have been through it. They've read it on, or read it in books, or seen it on TV. They're aware that they might end up with just having to go to a classroom, or having to write an apology letter, or having to write a letter to the school, apologizing for their actions. There's all kinds of different options other than just charging them.
Yeah.
I see. Certainly you come across marijuana a lot more than you come across alcohol. I think it's easier to hide. It's easier to carry. And I think that we detect it more easily. Although I would say over the last, 8 to 10 years that I've been doing this, you come across, marijuana is getting harder to detect in terms of the typical smells. So alcohol still smells. But I would say, we probably, if we deal with 50, let's say we deal with 50 cases of marijuana possession over a school year, we probably deal with 5 cases of alcohol.
I'd say that the amount of alcohol you see in a school is drastically smaller than the amount you see of drugs in schools.
Do you think it's because one of them is easier to obtain? Like it would be easier to get marijuana, or they choose that because it's their drug of choice?
I'm not sure if one's easier for them to obtain, given how prevalent alcohol is with parents and the accessibility at houses. I would just say that for some reason, that's what they choose to do at school rather than drink.
Which one's harder to get, alcohol or marijuana?
Alcohol.
Yeah.
And especially at our school.
Yeah.
Alcohol is harder to get.
It's harder to get.
Yeah. Why is alcohol harder to get?
Because you're underage and you have to get like an adult to buy it off to buy it.
Which one do you think is easier for students to obtain?
I would probably guess, I'm going to assume marijuana, right? Because I think they can, they have a lot more sources that don't involve their parents, although you would think that they could probably obtain alcohol from their own house. I think I'm basing that based on how often we come across it.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, both are detectable. You know, I mean, you smell alcohol on breath, or you smell marijuana cigarette smoke on somebody else. Either way, they're both detectable, but they choose to do marijuana over alcohol. I'm not saying mm-hmm. alcohol isn't here, but marijuana is more prevalent.
Why do kids feel safe smoking at school?
That's a tough question. I think that they're just to clarify the law, right? They're not allowed to smoke on school property. Nobody's allowed to smoke on school property.
Well, I mean, as you can see now, it's pretty quiet. It's dark. It's not very well lit, so it's a nice spot to come hide out. We're not patrolling it as much as we probably should be due to our extremely high call volume. But like I mentioned, it's a nice quiet spot for them to go.
We have very little vandalism at night around the building. I haven't had any reports about the forest. So in terms of lights, I think lighting in general, if it's done well, especially pointed downwards as opposed to just everywhere, helps deter.
Yeah, so I mean, it is with anything, theft, people breaking into residences. You want to deter people from having the ability to do it and being concealed while doing it. So for instance, this far corner here is completely black. It's a bushed in area. There is light standards here, but none of them are on. Obviously, they're trying to save money or whatever the reason yeah. being. But yeah, you light that up, or you actually enclose access, as in put a fence up so that they can't easily access it. They don't have to jump a fence or go around the other side, and you're not going to have them in that area. I mean, not saying that nobody's going to be in there, but it'll be obviously a less of a factor than it is now. Yeah, lighting's a big thing. If you can keep people from being hidden, then they're not going to want to be in that area if they're doing something they shouldn't be doing.
Who's in charge of the light standards?
The lights on school property are they're under the, I guess, the direction of the facilities department of the school board.
Okay.
So the school itself doesn't control where lights are placed or anything like that. There's a whole department that deals with facility.
And whether the lights are on or off during the night hours?
Again, it can actually be controlled at the board office.
Okay.
And now I'm coming from a very automated school to a school that's older, so I'm not sure if all the systems are still in place, but I'm pretty sure that every school, all of the heating and electrical and lighting and things can actually be controlled at the board office. Adjacent to our property, there's a high density neighborhood, right? And there's a pathway there that people use to get from that neighborhood to the school. And realistically, if we were to build a fence, they would make a gate if we didn't provide for a gate. So
we had a workshop, an anti-smoking workshop.
Yeah.
I was part of that. It was pretty cool.
Yeah.
So
like
a lot about, yeah.
Yeah.
Right. Wow. Any comments you
Any
wanna
comments?
Say?
That's pretty good, so.
Don't start.
Yeah, don't
no, start.
No,
that's
it's
your opinion.
So grabby.
So when did you start smoking?
Oh, I have to think on this one. Well, when I was grade 2, basically, because I got like peer pressured
yeah.
smoking, and yeah, that's about grade 2, and I really wasn't a big smoker until I hit high school, and I started smoking a lot, which I don't really like smoking as much, because it hurts so much, because I cough a lot now,
yeah,
which I'm probably going to quit pretty soon.
I like it.
Like, people should like come around here and just chill and like hang out around.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, because that should be a nice place around. Just
yeah.
like hang around.
Yeah.
Because I love hanging around here.
Yeah.
Like, you can just do whatever you want.
Yeah, it's a nice sport. Like,
you can actually do anything you want.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do you think if they put trash cans down, there'd be less crap everywhere?
Depends. Because there's a lot of like people who just like doesn't really care. So it's just like, screw it, let's go. Do something stupid, let's like burn this garbage or just like
yeah.
throw it around, like stuff like that.
Okay, boys.
Okay.
Woo, what a problem, man.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. Okay, so Chris, you want to give us a recap of what we accomplished?
What we accomplished was we spoke with Constable Dave Townsend from the OPP. We also got an interview with the principal from Twin Lakes Secondary School with Irfan Tor. That was a pretty awesome interview there. We got some testimonies from some students from the school. We also got some footage of the garbage and how bad it looks like in the forest near the school.
So some of the solutions we came across was for the littering, we could put down some garbage bins around the forest area.
Yep.
Maybe chain them to the ground so people don't, you know,
yep.
steal them or anything. But so it just gives a chance for teens to actually throw out their litter rather than just throw it on the ground.
Absolutely.
And the principal mentioned who owns or who's in charge of those light fixtures, so we can get in contact with those and have them running during the night, so that would deter individuals quite frequently, like the officer said. Some of the other things, oh yeah, the students with education.
Josh, would like to speak on that we have there?
I think from all the students, it's a bigger, they need more education on smoking and the effects that it has later down in your life. It may be cool now, but 15 years down the line, 20 years even.
See, building a fence around the forest to deter teenagers from smoking marijuana in the forest and littering. But the problem we have with that is obviously the funding that goes towards it, so can't really make that happen.
Another solution would just be belt kids you find smoking on school property after hours.
You're not moving in, I'm still under the shot.
Yeah,
we're going to
the shot.
There you go. Are you going to pass it over to me?
Yeah, sure. Jordan, any other solutions we should go over?
Well, we saw that there was only one sign posted for littering and loitering, and it was at the very front of the school, so away from where all this activity was happening. I think there should be maybe more signage around the school and the areas of concern.
Sounds like a great idea.
Yeah. All right, so is this problem solved, boys?
I believe it can be solved. Just, I think it needs more, a little bit more work. The signs, the education aspect, family upbringing is a big one. Even maybe get some counseling for parents.
Well, here, the guys at Problem Investigating Squad tried really hard, and we do think we found the solution to the problem. So, boys, bring it in. Piss on three. Three, two, one. Piss! Around the school smoking, it's definitely an issue that parents need to be more concerned about. Smoking marijuana off school property, now that's a big issue altogether, and I think it's one that the faculty of the school and the parents need to focus more on.
Why do kids feel safe smoking at school?
Kids feel safe because it's become a social norm for them. They see their friends smoking and they're not really being dealt with properly, and so what's to say if they start doing it they're going to be treated the same way, which is, you know, not being punished whatsoever. So I think that's why they feel safe.
So if marijuana was legalized, what do you think would be different?
If marijuana was legalized, it would definitely be more detectable. They wouldn't do it at nighttime or to avoid being seen doing it, so might give us more numbers. I mean, it might increase the statistics on how many people are smoking because it would come into view more often. But for the number of kids participating in the act, I don't think that would change.
So alcohol versus marijuana, what is a bigger problem?
I think right now, I think marijuana is the issue we should focus on because alcohol is pretty tightened down, you know. It's harder for kids, in my opinion, to obtain. And marijuana, you can go into any high school out there and you'd be able to find a dealer who can hook you up with marijuana. So I think marijuana is the bigger issue that we need to face.
What do you think would be good ways to deter marijuana smoking and drinking alcohol, minors?
A big way to deter it would be give more information on it. I remember going through high school only being told, you know, marijuana's a drug, you know, and it was illegal, and alcohol we later found out is a drug and it's legal. So there's confusion to what's good for your body and what's not good for your body, so there just needs to be more information about it. Like, look at cigarettes, the information's there, and I don't think it's reaching enough youth, but everybody's aware of the information on cigarettes, and that's why cigarette smoking has come down a lot. So I think the same could be done for marijuana.
All right, Chris, so how big of an issue is kids smoking?
In my personal opinion, I feel it's a big issue. I feel from the testimonies we got, I think, and from seeing from previous experiences and through my during my high school years, I think it's a big issue, especially the selling of smoking cigarettes and marijuana. Yep.
So why do you think kids feel safe smoking at school?
I think it's more of to do if they're trying to get away from their parents' house, so they're just trying to, it's, I guess, security issues or just their parents are not, you know, they're against it or something, so they're peer pressured to do it somewhere where, especially, let's say, for example, the forest or behind the school where, you know, they're on their own, you know, doing their own thing and parents can't see anything. So yeah. That's why I think it is like that.
If it was to be legal, what would be different?
I think if it was legal, yes, people would mostly be more comfortable doing it, but then they would, you know, I guess it'd be just more worse, in my opinion. You know, people would just, especially the young generation like you, if they would just be a bad example for, you know, seeing, you know, if it's legal, then so, oh yeah, why can't I do it? So it's legal, so I'll do it. Why not? So
which one is easier to obtain, alcohol or marijuana?
I think it'd be marijuana. It's a lot easier because connections, you know, it's also, you're doing it in the dark, secret, no one sees anything. Why, when you want to get alcohol, you have to show ID, you have to go to the liquor store, present yourself, and it's a lot harder. While with marijuana, you just, you know somebody, you get a phone call, text them, meet me here, and there you go.
Okay, how big of an issue is this?
Well, in my opinion, I think smoking is definitely a problem that's going on in the school right now. The kids definitely need some sort of support or education towards smoking marijuana or cigarettes in order to deter them from doing it.
Why do kids feel safe smoking after school hours?
They think that by, I don't know, going into a house or a forest, they won't get caught smoking marijuana. And
is education important on the matter?
Education is definitely a big one. If we educate kids at a younger age on the effects of marijuana and what it can do to you, then I think it definitely deter them from doing it at a young age.
If it was legal, what would be different?
If marijuana was legalized, I think people wouldn't be smoking in forests or anywhere else. I think they'd be more public about it because it'd be legal. But at the same time, it'd probably be more safe because it'd be regulated. So I mean, if they made the smoking age 18 or 19 for marijuana, I mean, it'd probably be better because young kids wouldn't be getting into it. And the younger you do it, the worse it is for you. You know what, I think alcohol and marijuana are pretty bad. Alcohol probably has some more severe risks, obviously, like death, or you can OD on alcohol. Then I don't think you can't overdose on marijuana. There's never been a case of that. So I think they're both problems, but I mean, alcohol is more abused than marijuana, in my opinion, I think.
All right, how do you stop kids from littering?
Well, if they maybe built more signs around the school area saying no littering, or if they upped the fines, or if they did anything like that.
An issue is kids smoking.
I think it's a pretty big issue.
I don't know what else to say.
Good enough, move on.
Why do kids feel safe smoking at school?
I honestly don't know.
What did they say?
Because there's nobody around?
Yeah.
Well, because there's nobody to regulate the tobacco industry, I guess.
Is education important on the matter?
I think so. I think the kids just think that it's cool to smoke. They don't know what the side effects are in the future.
Good. If it was legal, what would be different?
The price would probably go up. I think.
Alcohol versus marijuana, which one's the bigger problem?
With youths, I'd say alcohol. I don't know. They're both big problems, but I'd say alcohol is probably the bigger one.
Which one's easier to obtain and, you know, use after school hours?
Oh, they're both fairly easy to obtain. After school, I'd say probably smoking. Later at night, maybe alcohol use.
Okay, how big of an issue is kids smoking?
I think it's a pretty big issue. They definitely need more education on it. Because, you know, you see your peers doing it, and then it becomes peer pressure. So they definitely need some more education on it.
Why do kids feel safe smoking after school?
It depends. I don't know. It might be an insecurity thing where they feel that it's the best way to sort of release himself full of stress. So that's a way that they can cope with it. So I think that's a good way.
What percentage of the school population do you think are involved in these types of activities?
Grade-wise or...
How many? How many?
I'd say maybe 40-60%.
If it was legal, what would be different?
I think you find a lot more kids doing it, just because it's more of a social thing if it was legal. I also think the price would definitely go up from it for...
Yeah. How do you stop kids from littering?
I mean, you really can't raise the fines because, I mean, it's only the parents that are really going to pay for it. But I think, again, more education on it. Maybe get some earth programs or, you know, Save the Earth or something like that going. But other than that, I think, again, education is number one.